No retreat, no surrender. See what angry IPOB members are doing now in Anambra State as Nnamdi Kanu's trial begins. The IPOB members had reportedly blocked all the entrance and exit points of commercial city of Onitsha, Anambra State, and the industrial town in Nnewi. Reports gathered that the IPOB members want residents and visitors to stay at home in honor of their leader, Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, who is facing his trial today in the Federal High Court, Abuja. A close source in Onitsha told us that youths suspected to be IPOB members made bonfire in Moss Street in Onitsha and forcing vehicles entering the city to turn back. Following the rearrest and repatriate of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu to Nigeria from undisclosed country, he is expected to continue his trial after jumping bail in 2017, according to the video below. Shops, markets, and offices were locked in Onitsha while streets are deserted. It was further recorded that the youths were smashing cars belonging to motorists who disobeyed the order and attempted to enter into the city. A source who trades in Onitsha main market, Mr. Lezinus Eze, said, "We heard it yesterday as a rumor that there will not be market today, but this morning we found out that people were making bonfire everywhere in the city. Nobody has spoken to us about what is happening, but we learned that it is IPOB that is trying to force people to stay at home in solidarity with Nnamdi Kanu, who is appearing in court today." In the capital city of Anambra State, report has it that activities were going on without hinges. My dear viewers, you can see for yourself that Mazi Nnamdi Kanu is not just a personality, but a world personality. At least this should be should serve as a message to our leaders who are planning to send Nnamdi Kanu to jail, that Nigeria cannot be safe, and Nigeria will not even be safe for a day if anything did happen to Nnamdi Kanu. This is just a trial. See the tension a trial is just causing. Not that Nnamdi Kanu has been sent to jail, left alone if he's sent to jail or even be killed. My dear viewers, it means that Nigeria will truly come to an end. You know, when people are saying that Nigeria would completely be shut down if anything did happen to Nnamdi Kanu, it should not be taken for a joke. At least this very one that is happening in Anambra State should be an eye opener. It should be an eye opener to those doubting Thomas. You understand? So you don't doubt things like this. You don't doubt realities like this. At least this is a fact. You get it? And if you watch it again, aside from what has just been done in a way, the protest for Nnamdi for the release of Nnamdi Kanu is happening worldwide. It's happening in Israel. It's happening in Germany. It's happening in in Nigeria. It's happening in UK. In the whole world. So if the whole world are protesting just for one person, what message is that trying to pass to you too? Again, what message? At least that is to let you know that Nnamdi Kanu is not just a personality. He's more than a personality. He's a world figure, a known figure. So he is somebody that must not be underlooked or overlooked. So let the leaders of this country take note and cognizance of this happening, and start working on the immediate release of Nnamdi Kanu, and know it that nothing must happen to him. Nothing must happen to him. Some persons were trying to compare Nnamdi Kanu to Odumegwu Ojukwu. Yes, Odumegwu Ojukwu is a founder of is the founding father of Biafra, of a truth. Do you understand? But then we're now looking at who actually affected the lives of the people the most, because the person that is discovered that affected the lives of the people the most is who the people will throw more support for. You understand now? Ojukwu has population, he has support, but no one can have more support than Ojukwu. He has more support than Ojukwu. Do you know that in Nigeria here, now Nnamdi Kanu has been able to win over 90% hearts to the Biafran Republic. 90% personalities, people. That's what I meant. Now, even the so-called Northerners, we have over 50% that have developed interest to be a part of Biafran freedom, of Biafran Republic. You see that? So we need to think about this before plotting to send into jail. And that is why I will say that this very trial that they are just carrying out is a waste of time. It's a very big waste of time. They should not even think of it, of taking Nnamdi Kanu to jail, unless they want Nigeria to come to an end. It's not a child's play, but it is just the truth for those who doesn't know the truth, who are still doubting Thomas. You understand?